Hi, this is Rob. We're going to connect the Epson WiFi printer to a smart device using the Epson iPrint app. Then I'll show you how to print photos from your phone, print documents that are on your phone, print documents from your box, Dropbox, Evernote, Google Drive, or Microsoft OneDrive, how to scan a document on your printer and send it to your phone, how to capture a document with your phone and print it to the printer, and how to use your printer as a copy machine to make copies of a document. For this video, I'm using the Epson XP225 Wi-Fi printer in the Epson iPrint app. Let's get started. First step is turn on the Wi-Fi printer. The Wi-Fi printer takes about 20 to 30 seconds to connect to your Wi-Fi. When you first set up your printer, the software installation process will walk you through on how to connect your Wi-Fi. When the Wi-Fi light stops flashing and stays green, you are connected to your local Wi-Fi. For Epson printers, you'll need the Epson iPrint app. It looks like this. Here it is on my smartphone. I will open the Epson iPrint app. Here are the options. At the top, you have this information icon. I will tap on it. Useful information here is frequently asked questions, how to, and device information. Device information gives you information about both the smart device and the printer that it is connected to. Then down at the bottom, About, I will tap on About. I am currently using Epson iPrint version number 7.1.2. I'll go back again. Next step is to choose your printer from your local Wi-Fi network. Mine has already been set up, but if you're setting up for the first time, tap this blue area. Then tap Printer here. Tap on Local here, then the app will search for printers that are connected to the same Wi-Fi network as your smart device. Then you will tap on your printer to connect to the app. Manual IP. If you know your printer's IP address, you can connect to it by entering the printer's IP address. Remote print. Remote print allows you to print from anywhere in the world to your printer, but your printer needs to be an Epson email-enabled printer. You have to open an Epson Connect account. You have to register your printer with the Epson Connect service. Download and install the remote print software. During the software install process, you will establish an email address for your printer. Then, after everything is all set up, you can email a document to your printer from anywhere in the world and your printer will print it. Once your printer is connected to the app, your printer will display here. Also tap here to get some information on your printer. Printer status, my printer is ready to print from the app. Your ink levels in the printer. Scroll down to see more options. You can do printer maintenance, such as head cleaning, nozzle check, or even update the firmware of your printer. I'll tap on firmware update. It checks the latest firmware version on the printer. I just updated the firmware a couple days ago, so this should be up to date. And there it is, my printer is using the latest firmware. Settings. I will tap on Settings. It tells me that I'm not registered with the Epson Connect services, but if you want to register, tap here. This window pops up. This is how you would register your printer with the Epson Connect services. I will go back again. We are at the main menu area. If you want to print photos, tap here. This window pops up and shows the different areas where you have photos on your smart device. I will tap on camera here. I will choose one of these photos. Tap on select below. Tap on next here. The photo is displayed in black and white because in a previous printing, I had set the print color to monochrome. We're going to go to settings up here. This window pops up. You can choose the number of copies, the paper size, the media type, which is the type of paper you will be using in the printer for printing your photo. Here's where you can choose monochrome or color printing. I will choose color. I am done and will tap done here. When you're ready to print, tap the print button here. I'm not going to print this. I'm going to go back to the main menu. Print documents. We're going to print a document that is on the phone. Tap on the print documents button here. This window pops up. It'll tap on the SD card, and you can go to where your documents are stored on your smart device. I'm going to go to WhatsApp, the messenger app that I use. Go to Media, go to WhatsApp Documents. I will print this document here. We can go to Settings, just like we did when printing a photo. Printing Range. In Printing Range, if you have a multi-page document and you only want to print one page of that document, go to Printing Range. Uncheck the Print All button, then choose the Start Page Number to print and the End Page Number to print. All the other settings are self-explanatory. I will tap on Done in the upper right-hand corner. And in the lower right-hand corner, tap on Print. There we go. We printed a document from our smart device. You can also print a document from the cloud. Tap on this icon. This window pops up. You can print from your box, Dropbox, Evernote, Google Drive, and Microsoft OneDrive. I'll go back to the main menu. Scan. You can scan a document on the printer, and it will send it to your smart device. I will scan this pamphlet here. Place it on the scanner. Tap the scan icon on the main menu. Then press the scan button in the lower right-hand corner. The printer is scanning the pamphlet. The pamphlet is scanned. You now have three choices. Save the document to a file in your smart device, email this document, or print the document. If you press the Save To icon here, this window pops up and you can save to one of these locations on your smart device. I'll go back to the main menu. Document Capture. Document Capture is when you take an image of a document using the Epson iPrint app on your smart device. Tap on Document Capture here. This window pops up. Tap the Settings button and increase resolution settings when characters or photographs are blurred. So I want to capture this document here. This document is on my desk. First I will tap the Settings button. These are the options. I'm going to turn auto shooting off. Auto shooting will automatically capture the image once the app detects that everything is in focus. We'll go here to Save To. This is how you indicate where on your smart device that you want the captured document saved. It will go to resolution for shooting. Here are all the different resolutions that you can choose. I will stay with auto. I'll tap done in the upper right hand corner, then tap OK for this message. There are some horizontal lines. Line up the document. Tap the capture button in the lower right hand corner. Then tap the adjust button in the lower right-hand corner. Then you want to frame your document by adjusting these red corner dots around the document. Then tap on the document size in the lower left. You can choose these different document sizes. I will keep it on auto. Then click on the proceed button in the lower right. We now have more options on the bottom. I'll tap on Preview. This message pops up. Do you want to finish the adjustment? I'll tap yes. Below, we are given information about the document and another chance to change the document size. I'll tap on the print button in the lower right. It gives us printing options. I'll tap on done in the upper right. I'll tap on preview in the upper left. The document is still not saved yet. You have to tap on the save button in the lower left to save the document to your smart device. I will not save this and go back again to the main menu. Copy. Copy is making a physical copy of a document on your printer. We're going to make a copy of this document here. So place it on the scanner of the printer. Then tap the copy icon on the app. Here we can adjust any print settings. Now press the blue copy button in the lower right of the app. We have our copy. I'll go back to the main menu on the app. Okay, that is it. That is how to use the Epson iPrint app with the Epson Wi-Fi printer. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to this channel.